Good evening. As you know, many of you have been here from the beginning and through a little series of meetings to put together a workable budget for next year's school year. This is the final meeting. We were able to find from the state that we had a little bit more money coming back once the budget was voted on. And tonight we're going to try to disperse that money as fairly as possible, again, in order to continue and restore some of the programs for next year. I'll turn it over to Mr. Pacella.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Just want to do a quick recap for the board. Before I do, I just want to let everyone know that there was a handout up front when you came in that included the summary of changes that has been adopted or by consensus by the board. Also an alphabetical list of stuff that you're going to be discussing tonight. It's in your packet, board members have it in the packet. Based on what Mr. Pizzo just alluded to, that the state budget being adopted, the Newburgh School District did receive additional money. We received $250,000 from Assemblyman Scartados for no specific purpose, as did Beacon. Beacon received $250,000 and Poughkeepsie received $200,000. This was a member item given to the Newburgh School District that we were aware of prior to the spring break, and is included in the additional amounts that you're going to be discussing tonight. Also included for tonight's discussion is an additional $1,134,000 that we received from the governor's proposal based on the $250 million that was set aside for grants in his state budget. He pulled $125 million of that back and dispersed it to schools, and Newburgh saw a benefit of an additional $1.134 million. The board has reduced the current budget rollover from $240 million down to $227 million to fall within the legislative cap, the 2% or $2.63 million increase in the tax levy. The board, your charge is to pass the budget, adopt the budget tonight to be put before the voters. And I know that this is going to be painstaking, and I did have a discussion with council to find out if you do have any more time. We all know that the deadline is Friday for you to adopt the budget, according to state rules, but I know that due to the state convention, that may not be a problem. If the board budget is not adopted tonight, and we do not submit the property tax report card as required by the state, then you will not be able to put a budget before the voters on May 15th. By doing that, you put yourself up against the wall to only allow yourself to pass the budget one time. And that would be in June. If that budget is defeated, then the district would be automatically thrust into a contingent budget. A contingent budget means that the amount of taxes collected this year is the same amount of taxes that you have to collect next year. So in simple dollars, if right now we're experiencing $97 million in tax levy, if you go into a contingent budget, the budget gets defeated, you can only collect $97 million next year. Knowing that the current budget program that we have now rolled over to next year's dollars and contractual obligations of $240 million, you will be in the hole an additional $2.6 million from your cuts already experienced tonight. So you will have to go back to the board and come back with an additional $2.6 million from the $15 you already cut. But with that being said, you have before you the amount of money of the total $1,384,000. You have the alphabetized list, and Madam President, I'll turn it over to you.
Mr. Pacella, can you just speak a little bit also about things that are excluded in a contingency budget?
A contingent budget means that the board can only spend, or the district can only spend money on items that are contingent to the education of the students for their program as deemed contingent by the board. The items that come into play are certain equipment and facility uses by the public. The district can no longer allow private use or public use of our buildings without comparable costs. There are certain items that you cannot do with regards to emergencies. However, those are up to the board's discretion. Basically, biggest problem that the district did experience in the budget was, and the largest problem we had was with our facilities. A lot of the public wanted to use the facilities, and once they realized that there were significant costs above what you're currently charging now, because we cannot let our buildings out without recovering all the costs, it became somewhat of a media problem, as well as a relationship problem.
And then also, at that time, if I recollect, our local, we couldn't even use it, our own parent-teacher organizations, they had to pay for the space, the lighting, the everything as well. And in the past, the way that it was before, contingent budget could have, you know, I'll say, in the amount, been a higher amount, but in this particular case, that's no longer the case. A contingent budget and a budget vote going down means we have to cut an additional $2.5 million.
Correct. Under the new property tax cap, contingent budget does not allow you to increase your budget by the CPI cost times the current rate of inflation. This contingent budget means you can adopt any budget you want, but you can't raise taxes, which means you can only raise your budget by the amount of additional state aid that you're going to reap, or any other local revenue, which we know is not much. So contingent budget is far worse this year than any prior years we've had.
Thank you, Mr. Pissett. Just want to take a moment to thank everyone here this evening for all of their hard work and dedication to putting this budget together. It's been a team effort, and I appreciate all the time and energy that all of us have put into this very painstaking process. I'd also like to thank all of you sitting out there in the community. We have received many suggestions, many emails, piece of information from all of you. You'll hear amongst our discussion that we do take that under consideration, and now that we've been fortunate to have the opportunity to put some other things back, I know that not everyone is going to be happy, not everyone at this table is going to be happy, because we can't have everything that we want, but I certainly hope that we will be distributing this in a fair and equitable manner, and everyone will get a little bit of something back. So thank you all very much. I appreciate your time and energy.
Yeah, I apologize, Madam President, but today I did receive a phone call from a concerned taxpayer and parent, and I gave some erroneous information as I was caught up in everything. This morning I said that the board would be talking about the reserve that was released by the 1 year of adoption by the governor under his proposal. $2.2 million, and I was mistaken that you've already acted on that the last meeting prior to the break. What I should have told this taxpayer was that you're going to be acting on the additional state aid, so I erroneously gave that information today. And I just wanted to clarify if it was a mistake. You've already acted on that reserve by taking out the operating expenses for the unemployment, the workers' comp, and certain part of health insurance to cover with those reserves, so I just wanted to clarify that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pissell. Okay, so we have before us a list of things in regards to some items that we were going to consider now that we have this money back to put back into this budget. The first item for discussion, because this was something that I believe everyone was in agreement on, is in regards to the kindergarten teaching assistance. And we'd like to have discussion about putting back all of the kindergarten teaching assistance. That would be an add back to the budget of $886,716. Yes, Ms. Resch.
I think we were all unanimous on this anyway, that we didn't want them to go, and then we all wanted them to stay, but we couldn't because we didn't have the finances. So I can't speak for everyone, even though I know everyone is in agreement that they all want to back in.
comments in regards to putting back all of the kindergarten teaching assistants. I'll take consensus. Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
With that add back, you have available from the additional revenue $497,460.
Do any of the board members have another item they would like discussion on? Ms. Resch?
I changed my wish list when we got back this money. So I don't know how you want to do it. Should we just go around and say what we all want and then have discussion, or do you want to do one at a time? Or...
There's really no particular order here, so if you just want to...
Okay. I would like to see the final performing art director back. I just want to spread it out. I want to kind of spread the wealth out. So my wish list would be one science specialist, one instructional coach, kind of performing art director back, and instead of removing the hockey and crew altogether, making them into clubs and giving them the money to finance the equipment.
Yes, Mrs. McAfee.
Two things. One, we're having trouble understanding.
It's reverberating.
I can understand Don, though, and Mike, so the sound over there, it gets a bit horrible. Well, depending on what it is, that might be all right.
Greg, you're going to work on that.
I would like to put forward that I'm interested in seeing the money spent on spreading as much service to the children as we can possibly give them. And so I would advocate for there being a certain number of additional TAs brought back.
Yes, Ms. Prokash?
Administratively or anything like that, at this point in time. So that would be my two wishes.
attendance aids, because there was clarification, and I guess they were doing things, but they're not supposed to be doing those things, so it's actually going to be different employees that are going to be responsible for some of the things they were doing that they weren't supposed to be.
There are two set of employees up at the high school that work with attendance. We have callers and then the aides. Okay. The aides also call, from what I understand, but they were also responsible for some functions that we believe, and I believe the union would back us up, are out of title. Work that needs to be done by professional staff. So those duties would have to be looked at and assigned to some of the professional staff. They could not continue to do some of the duties that they've been doing all along. They did it because it was the best thing to do for kids. However, it is not an appropriate function of an attendance aid.
Would that be including like making the home visits and?
No, the home visits are covered in the contract. There are stipends that go along with attendance aides that do home visits. But I'm referring to counseling type services that may have been performed, and that is not appropriate.
It wasn't the counseling, it was actually the home visit.
Home visits are allowed in the contract.
Getting them back.
As long as they go with somebody, they're not supposed to go by themselves.
Correct.
Yes, Mr. Levinstein.
The suggestion that I had made for reference to bringing out a hockey skating crew was not to add back in the money that was appropriate for them, was to take that and divide that among all the varsity teams, so it's spread out among all of them, whatever 6%, 5%, 8%, whatever it is. This way it's a little more fair. We're not eliminating varsity teams, where we can just have everyone just take a little cut of it. All the other student athletes.
Well, we did do that, Mr. Levinstein, in that currently the hockey and ski teams are cut. The overall athletic budget line was cut by $31,421. We cut all the freshman sports. So athletics as a whole has been cut across the board already, as well as the assistants for some of the sports, five or six of them. So I think in looking at that, I don't think any, you know, I think that the cuts have been done across the board in that particular.
Just to add on that, the difficult piece about, because that's been recommended by a few citizens, the difficult piece about that is that most of the scheduling is done at the section level, section 9 at the state levels. So we couldn't pick and choose what games not to play, because it would affect other schools at certain levels. You couldn't pick and choose what buses to send the kids to. Certainly we've listened to the recommendations by the board. We are going to double up on the buses. We're not going to send cheerleaders to away games. So those are all cuts that are going to be made. To do a flat 10%, 20% across the board is not that difficult. It's not that easy. It's not as easy as saying that.
So, and you know, we also all received an email regarding how other districts are doing fundraisings for portions of these teams and having the district only pick up a portion of what they were previously. So perhaps we could have some discussion around that. We already have a ski club, so that's already in place, so that activity could continue with an affiliation around the school. If we were to look at a compromise and putting a certain amount of money back towards the crew and the hockey and making them clubs, it certainly would not be funded at the level that it had been funded at in the past, but perhaps that would be a
compromise to have a school-affiliated group for those three sports. Yes, Mr. Woodhull.
Yes, I can agree with the agreement that was brought to the vote with the science specialist and the Auditorium hockey and skiing group into clubs.
Comments or suggestions? Yes, Judy.
I don't understand how we could do a cruise as a club and make it any cheaper, since the expensive part would be personnel. And we've talked a number of times about the safety issue involved and a certain standard of coverage that we want to have. So would we have a problem making it less expensive?
If it was a club, the advisors to clubs receive a stipend of $253. So it would be a significant savings around the personnel. So if we looked at... No.
Make really their own schedule, the number of times per week, per month that they want to meet, what they do during those meeting times, how many children participate, that. So it's really, there's more flexibility with the club.
And also hockey and crew used to be clubs. It's only within, I don't even know how long, probably at least 10 years, that there were teams formed around those sports. So they originated in Newburgh as clubs. So some of the things that I believe we have to look at would be around recruit our assets. We have boats that we have to store. So we'd be looking at our storage fees for the boats. We'd be looking at the drivers that transport the boats. We'd be looking at the repairs to our boats. But as far as the payment for attending events and that kind of stuff, that would then be shifted to the club to do their fundraising. And apparently from the email I got, that's what some other districts are doing. They're covering stuff, protecting their property and what they're responsible for, and then the club is doing fundraising to cover some of the other costs that used to be covered by the district.
I'm just trying to imagine the kids out on the water practicing as they learn students. That's my concern.
Hockey, it would really be the the rental for ice time. Again, transportation and that kind of stuff could be provided by the parents. That's a huge cost in those, in any of our athletic teams. So again, in looking at, you'd have to look at the money, as we start putting stuff back, how much is left. But the board could assign, the board can afford, $10,000, $15,000, or whatever. You can be a club, we can contribute $15,000, and then they would be responsible for raising the other funds necessary.
And for satisfying us as far as coverage is concerned.
So something that would probably have to be looked at in regards to, because of the discussions we've had around the water and the routine and everything, would be, you know, would there be more than one advisor, you know, that would, again, it would be a stipend of $253, but maybe for that particular sport because of, or that particular club, because of, you know, the safety issues around the water, perhaps, you know, that would have, you know, three advisors or whatever. But again, you know, there would be a finite amount of money. So if the board says, okay, here's $15,000 to spend on your club, then, you know, then they would have to be responsible for, you know, what that's being spent on. Compromise that I was trying to have us all discuss. Yes, Mr. Woodhull.
Yes, I forgot to mention the music teacher for the music director.
That's maybe the financial guy. That'd be
the Fine and Performing Arts Director. Ms. Rush?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Not this one.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. McAfee?
No.
Yes.
Madam President, you have $324,323 left. It's 324,323.
2 of the 3 signed specialists. Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull? Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. McAfee? Yes.
You have $157,953.
Kindergarten teaching assistants, that's a Fine and Performing Arts Director, and that's 2 science specialists.
Correct. Can I ask where they were? It was closer down in... Two just by consensus came back. So which two? Closer town or more?
I think that has to be determined by HR.
Okay.
First thing you handed back, brought back to the TAs.
Oh, no, I wish it was here that we just went through, not that, for the 497,000 wasn't the TAs, 497,000 was the wish list we were doing, that's done just now. Do you other one was added back prior to 47497. Yes.
But we just got the money back.
First one you handed back tonight.
No, the one that we were just discussing, that we've been going around the table just now, was $497,000. It was not the TA's, that was activated back earlier. Am I correct in that?
That's not what I said. I said the first ones brought back tonight were the TA's.
But that was in reference to what I just said, that the first one brought back, when we were just doing the consensus, was the administrator.
That's right.
All right, well, then I misunderstood what you said. I apologize.
So I'm taking consensus on the instructional coach. Ms. Prokash.
I can't do that at this point, because to do it on an instructional coach, and then leave the music out when we've done the administrator, I have to stay low.
Mr. Levinson?
I'm going to take consensus on that, and I'm just going to make the statement that if we put that back and agree to take the $14,000 and find it somewhere else, then we're done, because we have no money left to put anything else back. Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Whipple?
No.
Mr. Beston?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash? Mr. Augustine? Mrs. McAfee? Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
So with the money we got back from the state, Assemblyman Scarpados, we have put back 17 teaching assistants, which will cover all of the kindergarten classes. We have put back 2 science specialists. We have put back the fine and performing arts director. And we have put back 2 music teachers, which will reestablish the instrumental music program beginning in 4th grade. Workshop. We have the special meeting starting 10 minutes at 7 o'clock. That would be to adopt the proposed budget for the May 15th vote.